something that you guys need to know about the challenge is that it's 8 weeks long. Okay? So, didn't know how that one was going to go over. 8 weeks, starting a week from Sunday. Okay, so it's Sunday to Sunday. Every 2 weeks, there's going to be like check-ins, okay? And a check-in is basically going to be you handing in the paperwork that we're going to have you filling out throughout this entire process. It's like a logbook where you're logging all of the things that I'm going to talk about. At the beginning, we're going to measure a few things. We're going to measure body composition. We're also going to do a performance test. So that's like a workout, by the way. And there are going to be very, very confidential before and after photos for you guys. For you guys and for, but just, so how did I come up with this stuff? And. You know, we've done previous challenges. There's a lot of gyms out there in the world, CrossFit gyms, that have put on challenges and that have published their kind of like successes and failures and things like that. And so I've compiled everything and come up with what I think are some good measurements that you guys can use to really help you see the results that you guys are getting, right? Because when it comes to like lifestyle and nutrition things, so many of us are just focused on one number, right? And notice that that number's not even on the board. And that number is typically your weight, right? Well, a lot of you guys aren't going to lose any weight. Some of you guys can lose more than others. And that doesn't mean that anybody's doing better than the next person, right? Because truly what we're after is changing our body composition, right? Changing how much body fat we store relative to lean body mass, which is what looks different in the picture and looks different in the mirror, but doesn't weigh anything different. And as a matter of fact, sometimes you gain a little bit of muscle and you lose some fat and you put on some weight, but you look and feel and are much healthier. Asking you guys to do here, we're asking you to, there are three categories where you guys can accumulate points for doing good stuff and good behavior. Workouts, food, and then this big category we're gonna call recovery. So we have tried to get people to just record their workouts in here when they come to classes as a way of like saying that, hey, you know what, that's actually going to improve your success and your performance and your you know, get you to your long-term goals faster if you guys are good about measuring these workouts. So that's one of the elements that we're going to encourage you to do in this process. So if you do, you get 5 points per workout, per watt a week. And that's up to 4 watts. Okay? So what is that? What counts as a watt? Well, you can come to class, and if you come to class, you must, actually, it doesn't really matter how you get these workouts done, you must record results. That means on the sheets that we give you, you have to write down the workout you did, the weights that you used in the workout, your rounds, your time, your reps, whatever the measurement of the day is. Okay? So classes are options. And then the other option is an out of town walk. Who doesn't know what that is? Oh, sweet. Most of you guys know what an out of town walk is. Basically, those are on our blog, right? If you go to tjsgym.com and you click on the blog link in the middle, you'll find relevant information to that particular day. You'll see what the workout that the class did, and you'll also see an option called the out-of-town workout, which is a modification of what we did in the gym so that you don't need equipment. You can do that at home. And if you record it, your results, what you did, you get credit for that too, 5 points. It's up to 4 workouts a week. Is that pretty? We're going to give you at the beginning of this when you sign up is a packet of log sheets and some like food guideline or info sheets as well. And that food guide on this, so the food list that you get is going to kind of dictate what you guys are allowed to have for your meals and what you can get points for. So there's going to be a meal category, which is breakfast, lunch, dinner. And each of these is equal to 3 points. All right? In order to get your 3 points for a meal, you need to actually eat it, so you can't skip your meal. That doesn't count. Less food is not better. Sorry. It needs to be from the list. So, from list, if it's a breakfast, lunch, and dinner, it must have protein, fat, and carbohydrates. So, the three macronutrients. Okay? And on that list that you're going to get is going to be all those things broken into different categories. This is the list of proteins. This is the list of fats. This is the list of carbs. Mix and match the way you want. Come up with some meals, recipes, things of that nature, and you cover it. If you have breakfast and you have an apple, great. Apples are good. It's on the list. But it didn't have any protein and it didn't have any fat, so you get 0 points for that meal. Okay, so this design was, seems simple, but it's kind of elegant in the way that it makes sure that you guys start actually having proper meals and balancing out what you're eating. So many of us get stuck on the list of foods that's acceptable. And you see a list from one of these books that we have over on the shelf, and you're like, I can just eat, oh, it's on the list, I'm gonna eat that, and that's my meal. And what you end up doing is you end up screwing up this idea of getting a balance of protein, fat, and carbohydrates, which is super essential for your health, okay? Prime example I already gave you was just grabbing fruit on the go and saying, that's a meal. That's not a meal. That's putting sugar in your mouth and that's it, okay? And so built into this is some strategies to help you guys sustain your satiety longer, so you feel full longer, and to really promote good hormonal balance over longer windows of time. Okay, there's also snacks that you get to have, and this is 2 per day. Okay, and each of these can be worth 2 points. And again, it has to be from the list, and I'm going to make this exception, so it's got to be protein, fat, carbs, or it can simply be protein and fat, right? If you don't have carbs in your snack, that's perfectly fine as well, okay? That'll, again, become more clear when you see those lists. Let's see if I miss anything. Any questions on that? I didn't miss anything.
Every day you get 3 points for the meals.
So you can get 9 points for eating breakfast, lunch, and dinner off the list that are complete. You can get 4 points for snacks. So there's 13 points possible per day for food. And, yeah. Question? Sleep. You're going to sleep, okay, but are you going to sleep enough? All right? And the way the points are broken down for this is if you get 8 hours of sleep, then we're going to call that go down to bed, and then from the time you go to bed to the time you get out of bed and go about your day is 8 hours apart, right? If you wake up and go to the bathroom, or if you're not, if at the beginning of this you're not a great sleeper and you kind of wake up a few times a night, stay in bed, and then you go back down, I'm going to say that's fine. Because ideally, we're going to hopefully, by the end of this, improve the quality of your sleep by making healthy lifestyle changes. But at the beginning, if it's not perfect, I just care that you're making sure that you plan out 8 hours of sleeping. That, you get 3 points. Okay? If you get 7 hours, you get 2 points. And if you get less than 7, you get a big fat 0. Okay? Or if you get your water in for the day, you get 2 points. Okay? Pretty important. That's 14 points a week for just drinking water.